water baptism, and I usually share this just about every time I do it, just so that we get the right idea. Water baptism doesn't save anybody. Does everybody know that? It's not a salvation thing. It's an obedience thing. And Jesus went to be baptized, and John the Baptist said, you know what, I should be baptized by you. And Jesus said, well, it behooves us to fulfill all righteousness. Are you hearing me? You hearing me back there? Okay. I speak up because I don't have a mic on, right? Okay. It behooves us to fulfill all righteousness. Jesus didn't have to be baptized because he didn't have anything to repent for, you know. But he said, let's allow it to happen. And what the water baptism is the baptism of John the Baptist, which is a baptism of repentance. And of course we know that Billy has already repented, and I just shared in a minute. He's going to claim Christ once again, as he's already done. But throughout the New Testament, throughout the book of Acts, I mean, the New Testament, and I know that we're going to have some of our people are going to come in, but, you know, it's okay with you to share with us, right? We're going to have some people come in and say, sir, you do that for me. I believe that Jesus
died on the cross
and was raised
to new life.
And I accept him.
And I accept him
as my Savior.
As my Savior.
And also as my Lord.
And also as my Lord.
William Eastland, Billy, by the authority of me as pastor of Central Christian Church, and as a member of God's family, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and in Jesus' name. Amen. Take, this is my body, and it's broken for you, Billy. He blessed it. He said, this is the cup of the new and the everlasting covenant. You didn't have to earn it. You didn't have to go to school for it. All you have to do is receive it. He said, this is the cup of the new and the everlasting covenant in my blood. I'm making a new covenant with you today. And give it to the disciples. He says, often as you drink this, remember what I've done for you. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, I just pray for Billy and his life. I pray for him in school. I pray for him when he goes to work. I pray for him when he's on that ball field. I pray for him when he's with his family. I pray, Lord, that you would continue to walk with him and let him know that you're there. I mean, we know you are walking with him. Help him to sense and know your presence. And Father, help him to understand that he's just entered into a family that is everlasting.